Hey guys, Alex here again. This is just a quick couple minutes on zooming and scrolling, okay? I'm just gonna save you a little bit of time zooming and scrolling. And actually, you'll thank me because the way that I'm going to show you is definitely quicker. Well, I guess it depends on what you're used to, but for me, I found as soon as I got into Bitwig that zooming in this way saved me a lot of time. So if you're used to Ableton, then you're used to going up here where you see the magnifying glass and zooming in like that. And that works, that's okay. For me, I personally wasn't a big fan of that just because I'm left kind of chasing where I really want to zoom in. And also, you're limited to how big your mouse tracker is or your however big your mouse pad is. And so what I like to do, if I want to zoom exactly where my mouse is, I press Control and Option, and then I just scroll up on my mouse pad or mouse wheel, or sorry, scroll. Well, for me, it's down. I guess it depends on your orientation. And then it just goes right to wherever your mouse is, okay? And that can save you a good amount of time. Because if I want to just make a quick edit, maybe I want to trim the back end of this, I can zoom right into it and I can grab it and trim it, okay? And the same goes if I'm editing MIDI data, then down here you'll see it's the same deal. I hold Control Option and I pull down on my mouse pad, or I scroll down on your mouse wheel or mouse pad, and it's the same thing. And in the edit mode, you'll notice if you scroll left and right, it changes the height of the notes, which can be handy because, see, here you have the names of the notes. If I zoom out, they disappear. If I zoom in, you can see them again. You'll notice though, if I click fold, and fold basically just gets rid of any notes that you're not playing. So it just shows you the notes that you've put in. Scrolling left and right doesn't work. I can't change the height of these notes. I can still zoom in like this. And to me, that's fine because when I'm folding MIDI like this, it means generally because I'm working left to right. I'm changing the timing of the notes, not necessarily the up and down placement of the notes. But that's my own personal taste anyway. And so just remember that if you hold Control Option and scroll on your mouse or your mouse tracker, then there you go. That's how I scroll anyway. And I think that if you get used to doing it that way, you'll find a much quicker workflow. Because if I'm working down here, I don't want to have to go up here and then sort of chase it around. And same with this. You can come up here, but then you're kind of chasing, you know? But you might be used to it if you're used to Ableton, and so that's fine. I think actually Ableton has that same quick command somewhere. But I don't know what it is, and also this isn't an Ableton show, okay? So just check into that. All right, see you next time.